me what you want, but you can't call me broke.
Money.
Pull up with that chopper and a telescope. Rah.
Love people, it's simple. Seeing is believing.
So you don't believe that Joan of Arc heard the voice of...
God? First you'll have to prove God to me.
Okay.
Okay, I'm right, or okay, you're actually gonna
take a deep breath, Farkle. Remind me what this does, please.
It slows down the speed of light and refracts it into the elemental spectrum of colors.
Ooh, rainbow.
That's right. So, this air that's between you and me isn't really clear at all, is it? Even though we can't see that.
Okay, but I don't see how that...
What's outside that window, Farkle?
Flowers, the fire escape, the street, the people on the street, apartment buildings.
And what's in the apartment buildings?
I can't see that.
People, families, mothers, fathers, kids.
Every person, every child, everything out there. Everything we see and we don't see. All these shining elements of a force that bond us together. I like to think of that as a part of God refracted. Aspects of God that I can see.
I said a prayer last night.
Can I say yay?
I am taking a risk making this video. But let's go. Reasons why you should keep on living. Number one, suicide is expensive. This dude paid $93,000 for an attempted suicide. That's crazy. Oh my goodness. And I don't know if I'm tripping or not, but this says over a milli, bro. What in the world? Number two, you may not be able to see Shrek 5 if you pass away. Number three, there will be one less cutie in this world. We need you. Number four, people care about you whether you believe it or not. Your loved ones will be heartbroken if you ever went away from their lives. And no, their lives will not be better off if you weren't there. You know who else cares about you? The creator of this world. For God so loved the world, he gave his one and only son, so whosoever believes in him shall not perish but have eternal life. The God of this universe, the creator of this world, loves you and wants a relationship with you. You are loved, and you do matter, whether you believe it or not. Grandpa loves you!
Why trust the Bible? Why not trust the Bible? It's ancient, so it's unreliable. Just because something is ancient doesn't make it false, just like something that's modern doesn't make it true. Well, scholars have confirmed that it's not true. It's actually not true. Many historians take the Bible and the New Testament especially very seriously. The Bible has been subjected to such vigorous literary and historical criticism, it's crazy, and has always come out unscathed. Not to mention, the Bible is the most studied and critiqued book in history. Why does that matter? Because it poses such a threat on humankind. If it's proven to be true, that means mankind has a responsibility to respond to the gospel. Okay, but what if those historians are wrong? They're not, and here's how we know. We can subject the Bible to three tests. The bibliographic test, the internal test, and the external test. What do they consist of? First, is the Bible that we have today the same as the original? The short answer is yes. The internal test asks if the Bible was written by eyewitnesses, and it was. And the external test asks, is there anything from the Bible that we can still see today? And we can, there's plenty of archaeological evidence of the Bible. I have to say, that's a strong argument. What can I say? The Bible defends itself.
Oh my goodness. Becky, look at her Bible. It is so huge. She looks like one of those preacher guys' girlfriends. But who understands those preacher guys anyway? They only talk to her because she looks like Mother Teresa, okay? I mean, but look at it. It's just huge. It's gross. She just looks so righteous.
I like big Bibles and I cannot lie. You Christian brothers can't deny that when a girl walks in with a KJV and a bookmark in Proverbs, you get stoked. Got a name engraved so you know this girl is saved. It looks like one of those large ones with plenty of space in the margins. Oh baby, I wanna read with ya, cause your Bible's got pictures. My minister try to console me, but that book you got makes
me so holy.
Ooh, mama mia, you say you want koinonia? Well, bless.
When God, back in the day, recognized a marriage was not when there was a wedding dress and groomsmen and cute pics on Instagram. That's not when the marriage was sealed. The marriage was consummated when the man and the wife came together in the marriage bed and they had sex. Because there's a blood transfer that happens there and all these things happen right in that moment. And God says, that's where covenant started. Like that right there, that's what I'm blessing. And this is the thing. When you have sex with somebody outside of marriage, you're saying I do without the covenant. How many people are you married to that you didn't really want to be with? I'm trying to tell you because nobody told me. And so I thought I was just being a guy and doing all these other things. And I'm sad to say I wasn't a virgin when I got married to my wife because I was trying to do things how society told me. But there were pieces of me that got taken prematurely.
Bye.
This is 9-year-old Taya, and on New Year's Eve, he was outside playing with his sister and cousins, when all of a sudden there was a gunshot and then he was on the ground. They then rushed him to the hospital, but to find out he barely had a scratch. When they went back to the scene of the crime, you won't believe what saved his life. It was his cross necklace that he was wearing around his neck. It had stopped the bullet, so if you could, write God is good in the comments, and if you believe in miracles, share this story.
Hi, very quickly. All Christians need to understand this, including me. Standing up for the oppressed and standing up against injustice is not merely an option for us. This is an obligation. It is a direct command from God. And so when we fail to do so, when we sit there and we let things happen, like homophobia, sexism, racism, and anything of that nature, or worse, if we participate in it, we one, become oppressors, and two, we are in direct disobedience to God. I mean, the Bible makes it extremely evident that Jesus Christ stood up for the defenseless, and as Christians, we know that we are called to be like him. And trust me, I fully understand that it's really hard to go out there and change the world, but simply using the voices and the hearts that God blesses us with can go such a long way. Listen, you may not be able to change the whole world, but you can change one person's world by standing up and showing them the love of Christ, and part of that is standing up for those who need it, standing with those who need it. Yeah!
We have lived in fear. We have lived in fear, and our fear has betrayed us. We will overcome. We will overcome the apathy that has made us. We are not alone. We are not alone in the dark with our demons. We have made mistakes. We have made mistakes. We've learned from them. And the sun, it does not cause us.
She don't see us? You see me?
Yeah. Yes, I see you. You see me?
Son of a frick. You piece of poop. You frickin' gosh darn fricker. Listen, poopy head. You have frickin' crossed the line. Get that through your gosh darn frickin' poopy head.
Wait. Stop. If you're a Christian, please stop. This may be the most important thing you ever see in your life. Just stop. Okay, hold on. Hi, my name is Kyla. Jesus took me to heaven and hell when I was 7 years old, and I'm trying to speak really fast so I can fit as much information as I can into this video. If you want to see my testimony, click on my picture and scroll from the bottom. This is a picture of your body, okay? Now listen, you've got eyes, ears, mouth, arms, torso, hands, legs, and feet. And then you have a veil of protection around your entire body. Now when you are alive, your physical body is your veil of protection. It's given to you by God. It is fragile and non-permanent, but it serves you to sustain your soul while you live and worship, but will decay because of sin and God's will for man's life to have shorter lifespans. So whenever you pass away, this is your soul. You are made in the direct image of God, so not only does your body reflect this, but your soul does too. Your torso is the vessel of your soul, so you are right here. Your legs and feet are for walking with God. Your hands and arms are acts of worship. Your eyes are for seeing God, your ears are for hearing God, and your mouth is for speaking and singing praises. In every way, your spiritual body is reflected in your physical body. And what you do in your physical body, your sins or your acts of worship transfer onto your spiritual body.
Previously on Genesis.
What a gorgeous day. I wonder how that came to be.
Who told you were naked? I don't know. I am not my brother's keeper, but I have to let you go. Goodbye.
Happy birthday to you. Abraham?
Thank you. We're so old.
Do you want the truth?
Spit it out, Abraham. I didn't forget the lamb.
I didn't laugh. We'll never bow down to you. Is this a joke?
Where are you from?
From the land of Canaan.
Who stole my chalice?
They're my brothers.
Yada, yada, yada. I'm just reading in my Bible, reading in my Bible.
Hey, kid. Oh, not you again. What do you want?
Still reading your word? You lame.
That's cool. That's what's up. It's cool.
What? Guess what? Your religion's not real.
Oh, that's your opinion. Okay.
What? I sin every day and I feel just fine.
Well, yeah, I get it, I guess.
What?
What's your problem?
You won't retaliate.
You're right. You know what? I'm not gonna retaliate.
What peace you must have. How are you staying this calm?
The fruits of the spirit. You should learn about it. It's nice.
So it's like actual fruit?
Nah, it's just words. Just words.
Oh. Can I learn about it?
Can you learn about it?
Of course. Sit down. Thanks.
No problem, man.
I guess I wrongly misjudged you guys.
What you mean by you guys?
Oh, y'all Christians.
Yeah, you did, but it's cool.
Christianity's just overdone. I mean, it is. There's not a single person I could walk up to and talk to who has never heard about Christianity. I mean, that's a fact. But then why does nobody understand it? You see, if I were to ask the average person watching this video, what is Christianity about? They tell me it's about living your best life. It's about being good. They mention the Ten Commandments. They maybe even say something about Jesus. But that is wrong, and if you say that, then you'd be completely wrong. I mean, it's never been about being good. It's never, ever been about being good. The law and the morality in the Bible only exists to show us that we can't be enough. The law can detect our sin, but it can't defeat our sin. And that's why we need Jesus. Here's the good news. Jesus lived a perfect life. He did it because he was God. He died on that cross, paying the penalty that we deserved for our sin. And because of that, we don't have to be good because Jesus did it for us.
I don't know who needs to hear this, but God does not work the same way today that he did in Bible times.
There was a little girl named Jenny who had cancer. The doctor gave her 6 weeks to live. The church came and prayed over her. Somehow, some way, the cancer began disappearing. It was a medical miracle. The doctor told her that because she had so much radiation damage, she would never be able to have kids. And even in the slightest chance that she did get pregnant, she would either miscarriage or her children would have a lot of deformities and special needs. Jenny is my mom. She has 3 healthy kids. The only issue I have is asthma. The fact that I even exist is living proof that God still works today. I don't know what your church has been teaching you, but God absolutely still works miracles today. I wouldn't be here if it wasn't for prayer. I think the church needs to stop telling God what he can and can't do.
A shortcut to the chum bucket. That must be for me. This isn't the chum bucket.
Hello there. Here's a Bible shanty.
There once was a man from Galilee, and the name of the man was the big JC. He bore his cross and thorny crown, but still his love did show.
No one's gonna stop you, Lord, the world has been yours.
One day when the supper is done, wait, where did Judas go?
Say it loud.